town. Here for a quick meeting and then back to the studio. My meeting's over, it went very well. Do you guys remember back in season one of the vlog when I used to run around the city doing time lapses? Oh, hey guys. I miss that, and that's what I'm...
Casey.
What's up?
I love you, man.
Hey, I was just on that billboard.
Yes, my wife is on this billboard.
I wish I got it. I could have put it in the vlog.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G.
Nice to meet you guys.
Appreciate it, man.
Well, in any event, that's what I'm doing now. I was like in Times Square and I was like, I want to go back downtown, but I got my extra camera with me. So I'm just up here shooting beautiful time lapses. Okay, I'm going to go back downtown now. All right, that's it. I'm going back to the office now. I'm freezing. See, this is the problem with the city. I meant to just go to a quick meeting in Midtown, then skateboard back, but I kept getting distracted by all the interestingness in this town. Just finished my soup. Now I'm going to the office. Candace! She was waiting?
Waiting. Like, she was that one tear coming out of her face.
She was upset?
The lady was waiting when that one tear coming out of her face.
I got a girl.
You were waiting?
Yes, you said 90 seconds. I've been here for like 8 minutes.
Wait, no, I'm just coming to tell you one thing. The verdict's in, they want a podcast.
I can't wait to see how many people say, oh, her voice is so squeaky.
You're still into it though, right?
Yeah, mostly because like, when else am I gonna get you to sit down and talk to me about stuff for half an hour at a time? It's gonna be awesome.
See you later. You look cute today. Bye. Here's a not so funny, but totally true story. This scene that I'm shooting right now, right here, right now with you, I already shot this. I shot this whole scene yesterday, but the audio was all messed up, so I had to come back in today, which is tomorrow, and reshoot this whole thing on a different camera setup because yesterday the audio was all crackled. Listen. That's up, right? This is what the new camera setup looks like here. See, I got my old Sony, great camera, microphone here, got the new Joby Gorilla thing, and then I had to put a monitor on it because Sony inexplicably. And then I had to put a new monitor on it because Sony inexplicably does not put a front-facing monitor on any of their cameras. Okay, so now you're probably asking yourself, what is this scene? Well, the OG vlog viewers might remember this. That was the Q&A intro from season one. I haven't done Q&A in a while because people just kept asking the same questions and then I just kept giving the same answers. I haven't done it in a while, so here we go. Madeline wants to know, should I go to college in San Diego and finish debt-free or go to NYU, my dream school, and acquire a lot of debt? Okay. I think there are two paths that people take when pursuing higher education. Path number one, I don't know what I want to do in life and maybe I can figure out what I want to do by going to school. If that's the boat you're in, definitely go to the school you don't have to pay for. Then there's scenario number two. In the startup world, there's this term, and the term is swinging for the fences. That means you get up to bat and you're not looking for a base hit. You're looking for a grand slam, out of the park home run. And anything less than an out of the park home run is not what you're interested in. The thing about swinging for the fences is if you connect, home run. If you miss, you're out. If you know that you're gonna be some millionaire superstar, that you are the next Steven Spielberg and the only way to get there is by going to NYU, then it. Accrue as much debt as you need to accrue because you're going to be a millionaire someday. Swing for the fences. But if you're not sure, I would go the conservative route. Don't go in debt. Get an education. Do the right thing. When's the podcast coming out? I've got some travel coming up this week and a bunch of other things. I got to figure that out and then figure out how to do a podcast. But soon. Is your work ethic so crazy because of what you've been through in life, or do you think you were born with it? The single greatest driving factor I have in my career and my focus in life is an absolute fear of going back to the place where I started my adult life. Being dirt poor, not being able to provide for my family. I was sort of ashamed that I couldn't take care of my family. And having that in my rearview mirror, it definitely pushes me to work harder today because of that kind of irrational fear of returning to that place where my career and my adult life began. Where do you put your cell phone when running? I keep it in my hand, like this. Because if it's strapped to my arm or on my hip, it like bounces, it's too much. What are your thoughts on Bitcoin? Extremely pessimistic in the short, extremely bullish in the long. Milk or cereal first? What kind of a sick, deranged human being puts the milk in before the cereal? Then it's just gonna float on top. You put the cereal in, then you pour the milk. Do you take time for self-reflection or meditation? No, but running for me is very meditative. Running for me is a cerebral activity. It's why I value it so highly. Do you think you would have been as successful if I had not moved to New York City? No. I mean, I could have never found a career in video and movies in the small town that I came from, but that's changed. You know, when I started making movies, YouTube didn't exist, social media didn't exist, and now I think that anybody with the drive and a camera, even if that...
Yesterday you gave me the other people's mail.
Fool you?
Yeah, I like opened
in the bottom?
It. I like opened it and it was e-cigarettes and I'm no smoker.
Uh-oh, sorry.
Because of the internet, because of social media, I think you can now build a career and find a career simply by, you know, using your cell phone or a camera or whatever your tool is. I think you can succeed almost anywhere. I didn't have that luxury when I started my career. By the way, this the tweet that I did for this Q&A has 4,900 questions, so if I didn't get to you, I'm sorry. All right, last question comes from Roberto. Roberto, by the way, great YouTuber. You should all follow this guy.
Hey, Casey, it's Roberto. So my question for tomorrow's Q&A is if you could wave your hand and change three things about YouTube tomorrow, what would you change?
You know, Roberto, for me, it comes down to kind of one thing, one gigantic change that I would love to see YouTube make. I would love to see YouTube put a lot more effort into publicly showing a much greater appreciation for the creator community. Meaning, you know, during the World Series, I love seeing YouTube TV, which I'm rooting for, advertised on the World Series. Sometimes I see YouTube advertisements in magazines or in billboards and things like that, but they always seem to be for Red or for TV or other aspects of YouTube than the creator community. So since I'm a part of this community and I'm always rooting for this community, I would love to see YouTube just kind of publicly, loudly celebrate this community.
The YouTube community is the greatest thing on planet Earth.
You know, I'd love to hear YouTube say that because I think the YouTube community is the greatest thing on planet Earth. And I think a lot of the discontent that you hear YouTubers voicing is because it does kind of feel like we're often operating in a vacuum.
Hey creators, we hear you and we appreciate you and we want you to succeed. And here's what we're doing to make that happen. All right, that's it for today's Q&A.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G.
We've been watching a lot of Peppa Pig lately. I can feel it making me stupider. You think Peppa Pig makes me stupid? No? Vote of confidence.
You don't say stupid.
Don't say stupid. You don't say stupid. That's a bad word.
I got a gas. A, B, C, D.